The goddess as light-bearer is also metaphorically conceptualized as lighthouse, helping to bring Luciferian travelers out of the deep sea abyss and toward the safety of the shore, which is a metaphor for divine illumination. The goddess is likewise metaphorically portrayed as offering an umbrella of protection from the proverbial storm. The House in the Woods, also called the Hill House, Hell House, HH, Luciferian Ascension Code 88. This house in the woods represents a place of shelter from the woods or wilderness, metaphoric for the underworld abyss realm. The Luciferian journey is conceptualized as involving dimensional transit, first downward through the lower veil to the underworld abyss realm, then upward through the upper veil, the so-called bounding membrane of the Pleroma, and into the divine spiritual realm of the cosmic god. A dimensional transit vehicle is often depicted as facilitating transit through the veil. A ship, boat, or raft is often portrayed as a Luciferian symbol of shelter, refuge, and transit above the turbulent waters of the deep sea abyss. Other dimensional transit vehicles depicted in Luciferian popular culture media include the bicycle, the bus, the submarine or yellow submarine, the rocket or spaceship, and the car or truck. A car is often portrayed as a vehicle of dimensional transit down through the lower veil into the underworld abyss realm. This journey is often metaphorically depicted as ending in a car crash, wreck, or motor vehicle accident. This is metaphorically meant to indicate that the downward journey is a journey of no return. Once, then I check it twice. Oh, look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me do. Oh, I'm crazy. No, nothing you can do will save me. In Satan's religion, it is said that Yahweh, as the Demiurge, works to impede the journey of Luciferian travelers. In occult imagery, Yahweh is depicted as running interference, sometimes as a giant octopus or sea monster, attempting to sink the ships of Luciferian initiates. Yahweh is also depicted as a shark, lurking in the waters of the deep sea abyss, also called the wilderness or woods. In the demonic doctrine, it is said that Luciferian travelers who make the journey of descent into the underworld realm have an encounter with the divine feminine goddess.
Fall into her arms as she shatters.
goddess is conceptualized as a muse, and she is described as having an underground temple, city, palace, or secret chamber in the underworld. Luciferians speak of looking into the eyes of the goddess.
I could swim in your eyes. Hope that the tide doesn't drag me up. I could swim in your eyes. Deep in your love, and I wanna drown. Don't leave me broken hearted, all alone 10,000 leagues. Cause underneath the water, you're the only way I breathe.
Keep me in your prayers, got me running scared. You turn me into someone I don't wanna be. But I don't even care though, I'm dead and unaware though. I only feel alive when you hurt me. Spend whatever on you, spend a minute on you. I know I'm gonna lose, I do it anyway. There's a killer in you, and it's killing me too. I know I'm gonna lose, I do it anyway. Don't tempt me with those tinted eyes. This don't feel right, I should know better. Just like a sin, those tinted eyes. Hold your disguise, I should know better.
The girl with kaleidoscope eyes. The divine feminine goddess is described as the girl with kaleidoscope eyes.
Against the wall, I don't know what I'm saying. Why is it so hard to believe it'll be okay? Oh, feels like all is lost. I don't know what to do. I'm probably gonna cry. I can't hide it from you. Something in your eyes like a light. Your hips on mine, colors in my head explode just like
green-eyed goddess. The divine feminine goddess is sometimes referred to as the girl with green eyes, the green-eyed girl.
Green-eyed lady, lovely lady, strolling slowly towards the sun. Green-eyed lady, ocean lady, soothing every raging wave that comes.
Luciferians describe being surrounded and embraced by the goddess, flooded with the love of the mother goddess. In popular culture media, such encounters are described as transient and fleeting. There are many songs wherein the singer describes a prior connection with Lucifer as the underworld goddess. The goddess is described as exceedingly beautiful and enchanting, and she is often depicted as having endowed the illumined Luciferian with divine love, light, knowledge, or power. Luciferians often speak of how the goddess was gone too soon, saying such things as, "I didn't want it to end. I didn't want to go back." They are occasionally portrayed as wondering if their prior encounter with the goddess was real or a dream, and they speak of desperately wanting to have another encounter with their beloved goddess. In the pagan mystery religion, the profane realm is conceptualized as night, and the divine spiritual realm is metaphorically conceptualized as day. Accordingly, the sun god Nimrod or Osiris is said to be the light that rules the day, and the moon goddess Semiramis or Isis is the light to rule the night. It is said that in our current profane existence, the sun is eclipsed, and Yahweh as the demiurge is considered to be the eclipsed sun god or black sun. In the Egyptian variant of the religion, the sun god Osiris is killed by Set or Typhon, and thus, Osiris is said to currently reside in the grave, Sheol, the underworld abyss realm, also called the secret chambers. This is why the Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, warned us not to seek out this false messiah, who dwells in the metaphoric dry land or desert, also called the secret chambers.
Wherefore, if they shall say unto you, Behold, he is in the desert, go not forth. Behold, he is in the secret chambers. Believe it not.
We're going to talk about, specifically about your book, The Black Awakening. The subject matter in this book is very serious. It has to do with, let's call it demonic activity for the moment, and I'm not sure that covers all the bases, but we'll get into that.
Because I think this, the book, it's got a strange title. And we tell you why in the beginning of the book. The title comes from one of the, from Fort Bragg, a Psi warrior, one of these powerful chosen ones, Dark Psi. They knew dark rituals, dark powers. They told me one day, Russ, you believe in revivals like Jonathan Edwards and the revivals that struck. We believe, Dark Psi, Satanists believe, we're going to bring about a counterfeit Pentecost. We're going to bring about so much dark power in the world. And we're going to bring a chaos. It's going to collapse everything. Then we're, our new world order is coming. Now, this is what they've told us.
And they really believe that.
And they really plot for it.
Wow.
You would not believe the fierce, I call it a fury inside them, wanting to bring this about. And they believe, whether we believe it or not, they believe. We're talking 25 years of working with them from all over, hundreds and hundreds. They believe they're being created to be the troops of Antichrist. They say the Black Awakening's the collapse that will cause a tearing down to bring a new order that they will help usher in.
You know, we watch the world today, and something has changed. Certainly. It's not the same world that we grew up in. And there seems to be some kind of a quickening change of events. And that's what you're talking about. These entities, demonic entities, whatever you want to call them, feel that now history is on their side.
Exactly.